This is ACDN TV. Welcome back, AC. It's Friday, April 5th. I'm Braden Keener here alongside Ryan Barrientos, and we're back for your ACDN TV weekly show.
We got a fun show for you today, and later in the episode, we'll bring back the much loved Mean Tweet segment. We'll also give you some news, including the Baltimore Bridge collapse that occurred last week, as well as some delicious news for those donut lovers.
But now, we brought together some students and teachers to compete in a competition that asked them to identify a cartoon character just by looking at their eyes. How did they do and who came out on top? Let's find that out now.
I'm Ms. Jabinski, and I think I'm gonna win today because I have been on this earth longer than Lucas has, so I've seen many more cartoons, and I am a 90s baby, so 90s cartoons all the way, and Disney movies.
Hello everybody, my name is John Lee, and today I'm gonna win this competition for the sake of my ego, to boost it up.
I'm Jackson Winters. I'm not going to win this.
Okay, well, I'm Bernard. I'm hoping I win this.
Mario!
I knew that one!
That's Mario.
Bruh! I didn't realize!
I got that point.
For now.
Oh, I was gonna say like a Batman, but never mind.
That is correct.
Hey, what actually
Way
is?
Go, Batman.
It actually is like Batman? I thought it was like Storm or something.
No, not cool.
Batman.
Lego Batman! Lego Batman!
Wait.
Is that, Zazu from Lion King?
Wait, I should know this dude. It's a dud, that part's a dud.
Bluey.
What's Bluey?
Yeah, I don't know what that is either.
Australian children's cartoon.
Oh.
I am Aussie, mate.
Oh. Bluey! Oh, take the L. Take
You're lucky
L.
I didn't know the name. I would have got that one.
Garfield!
Oh, come on. I knew that one.
Garfield!
Oh. Is it Rapunzel from Tangled?
Yes.
Yes.
I was gonna say Anna from Frozen.
Rapunzel!
There's no way!
I hesitated there.
Mabel Times.
Mabel from Gravity Falls, right? Let's go!
What am I supposed to do? I don't know any of these people. I just ran a pacer, like, I don't know.
Dopey.
Yeah.
I don't really know. It's from Space Jam.
Dopey! Right? Yo, no!
This is so fair.
Was that the... Remember when you did your intro presentation?
Is it on Hatsune Miku?
Yes.
Hatsune Miku! Thank you, Lucas! Courtesy to Lucas, I don't actually know who that is.
Arnold.
Arnold from Hey Arnold. My dad looks like
Dude,
him.
How about we pull up some like motocross brands or something, you know?
Homer Simpson.
Bart Simpson.
Yes.
Okay.
Simpson, Bart Simpson. No! Homer Simpson!
That's Bart Simpson.
Oh my god, you got 2 points!
Bro, shut up.
Yeah.
You know, the reason I lost is just because I'm not a child, so I don't watch cartoons.
Well, miss, child or not, I still beat you.
Is this what you do at home? You practice this?
Yeah.
You go home and study these people?
Cooks!
In shambles.
Kalani absolutely killed it. I think I could probably have identified maybe 2 of those.
Yeah, I think Bart Simpson was the only standout for me.
On some more serious news, I'm sure most everyone has seen the news about the Baltimore Francis Scott Key Bridge that collapsed last Tuesday in the early morning hours at about 1:30 a.m. A cargo ship the size of a skyscraper hit the bridge after it lost power. Fortunately, there wasn't any traffic on the bridge when it collapsed since the crew issued an urgent mayday. First responders stopped the traffic before the ship drifted into the bridge, causing the bridge to bow and snap. Although there were no people driving on the bridge, there were still 8 construction workers fixing the potholes on the bridge who fell into the river below. Sadly, of those 8, 6 did not survive. The investigation is still ongoing, but estimates say it'll cost at least $400 million to rebuild the bridge.
Definitely tragic news, but I do have some good news to share. Good news about a Goodwill gala that will take place tonight in the cafeteria for high school students from 7 to 9 p.m. The cost of this dance is just $1, and you're asked to wear anything you pull out of the closet. In fact, if you really want to have some fun, close your eyes and just grab some random things right out of the closet and wear them. You can't beat the cost of $1 for 2 hours of entertainment on a Friday night. And if you aren't headed to the dance, you can check out some March Madness games. The women's basketball NCAA tournament has been a big hit for not just basketball fans. Everyone is enjoying watching these intense matchups. On Monday, LSU played Iowa, which was a very close game. Iowa came for redemption, and they got it. In fact, there were 12 million viewers for Monday's game. As a result, Iowa gets to move on to the Final Four on Friday night. Make sure to stream the 2 games. NC State plays South Carolina at 7 p.m., and UConn plays Iowa at 9:30 p.m. These games will definitely be fun to watch.
And now we're pleased to bring back the segment that strikes fear through the hearts of teachers throughout the school. The teacher mean tweets. Let's see if we took mercy in them, or maybe not.
At Barnes Student. So I can only imagine who this would be. At Bald Eagle. That's another good one. You let more people pass in the hallways than you let your quarterback pass in a season. Pretty good. I like that one. That was great. Hashtag triple option. Hashtag run the offense. Hashtag stay little. Me, little. Okay, it's good. Good. Congratulations.
So at Mr. Breakfast, do you need help with completing your sentences? Question mark. King of Yap, let the teacher teach. Hashtag LVC lick. You can see I do say a lot, but it happens sometimes.
I'm nervous. Okay. At C. Heller Taylor's version, you run races just like you run through your lessons. Too fast. Hashtag speed isn't always key. That's so mean. You said a teacher wrote this one. Ow!
Ow! At PA Pens fan, how is the water bill hitting? Hashtag grounded. Hashtag water boy. I thought we were over these jokes. I thought we were past all this. We'll take it in stride and we'll be okay. You're welcome for the new gym.
Who wrote it? Who wrote it? Was it Clem? Who wrote this?
Okay. At Luscious Lum, how do you get juked so hard your knee pops out of sockets? Hashtag need a walker. Hashtag where you're going. Thanks a lot, guys.
Oh my gosh. Well, I mean, at least they're saying, like, I'm fast, right? So I'll take it as a compliment. But really, who wrote it? Do I go through my lessons too fast? Because I feel like I actually, like, teach kind of slow sometimes.
Your haircuts are like the life of a cell. There's always new ones, but they always die out. All right. I mean, that's not bad. Could be worse.
At your average tennis coach, how do you go to Disney World more than you have a class? Hashtag grand champ. Hashtag teacher no teach. I mean, somebody's gotta get paid money to do nothing all day, according to you, right?
Hold up. Let him.
I gotta take a poll. Hey, Ollie, do I teach too fast? Thank you, thank you, thank you. Okay.
Oh, I think those could have been way more brutal for sure. In case you haven't heard the news, there is a partial eclipse happening Monday afternoon, and AC students will be dismissed at 10:30. Don't forget to leave with a pair of glasses so that you can view the eclipse, but remember, do not look up. That is the most important thing.
I can't wait to try on those glasses and be able to see it. And since we're going home early, how about some fast food news that may get your taste buds watering? Wendy's just released a new flavor of Frosty just in time for spring or the solar eclipse, a creamsicle Frosty. And if that doesn't do it for you, how about the news that Krispy Kreme donuts will now be sold at McDonald's? That's right, you can look forward to their new partnership with Krispy Kreme, which will be nationwide by the end of 2026. Last year, they found these donuts were a huge success in Kentucky and Indiana, where Krispy Kreme donuts were already being sold at 160 McDonald's locations. McDonald's now plans to make three Krispy Kreme donut varieties: original glazed, chocolate iced with sprinkles, and filled chocolate iced, and they will come individually or in boxes of six. This new addition to the McCafe is something we can all look forward to in the future.
If you're someone getting spring pictures, be aware that they'll be occurring on Wednesday in the Grand Hallway during the morning. The schedule that you may follow will be posted on Schoology. For ACDN TV, I'm Ryan Barrientos.
And I'm Brayden Keener. Enjoy your weekend, AC.